a new grind. I got a question for you. Are you living life, or is life living you? How bad do you want to be successful? Are you ready to level up in life? Are you ready to go to that next level? Are you sick of being average? I ask you again, are you living life, or is life living you? Less than unstoppable, the international world tour, Dr. Billy Osbrooks, coming to a city near you. I'll be teaching a 4-hour, life-changing seminar on the art of greatness. Arise, champion. Every city will sell out. Get your tickets now. This year, we're taking this thing global. 27 cities, Toronto, London, Paris, Rome. We're coming to impact 1 billion people. If you are serious about success, be at one of these events. Get your tickets now at blessedandunstoppable.com. That fire take you up out of here.
Fire.
Keep burning. Keep burning. Keep burning. That fire take you up out of here.
You can't think your way to the next level in life. You have to burn your way there. You see, it's the burn, that fire on the inside that makes the music. Fire, truth, music. That thing you think you're missing in life. See, it can only be found in the center of that flame. Now, when I say fire, I'm talking about your passion. What are you most passionate about in life? Don't let the heat intimidate you. Don't let that fear choke you to death. Don't let that fear stop you from being all that you can be. That fear ain't from God. For the Lord didn't give us a spirit of fear, but a power and of love and of sound mind. Truth can only be understood fully from the center of one's calling. The fire produced from doing your passion brings clarity to a world of chaos. So what you gotta do is dive into the truth, and the world will illumine with your fire.
Keep burning, keep burning, keep burning.
That fire take you up out of here.
Fire. Keep burning, keep burning, keep burning.
That fire take you up out of here. You don't change your life by trying not to be something. You change by becoming something better. See, I stopped missing yesterday when I realized that missing it wouldn't bring it back. My success today drowns out the longing to be back there. The secret to success is building your life around doing the things that you love. Excellence is impossible to attain without a burning desire to achieve it. Set yourself on fire and the world will come see you burn. You see, passion wrapped with discipline will make room for you regardless of whether haters like you or not. Don't let the heat intimidate you. Don't die doing that 9-to-5. To thrive and be successful, you will have to do what makes you feel alive. Look, those who have awakened to themselves know they need not worry about money because fire is always in demand. Most of the world has it wrong. You hear people say, when I get enough money, then I'm gonna do what I love. You got it backwards. Do what you love. Do what sets you on fire. Do what makes you feel alive, and the money will flow to you all day long.
Keep burning. Keep burning. Keep burning.
That fire take you up out of here.
Fire. Keep burning. Keep burning. Keep burning.
That fire take you up out of here. Every day when you get up, I want you to ask yourself this question. Am I dead or am I alive? Am I choking or am I breathing? Am I lukewarm or am I on fire? Seize the moment before destiny gets restless. Now I speak the parable. The one who is fully unleashed will sit still and project her love to the one who knows her real name. When your spirit is quiet and still, you will awaken to your purpose, to your calling, your reason for being here. Then light up. Don't let the heat intimidate you. Your passion, your calling has been there waiting on you all along. The spirit in you understands the words that I'm saying, but the rest of you is still transitioning to awareness. The world has blinded you to who you really are. You've been in a coma with amnesia up until now. But this message right here is your alarm clock, and I'm speaking directly to your spirit. Arise! The days of the blind are no more. The season is over. Truth shall awaken the king, and the fire in him shall burn forever.
Fire! Keep burning. Keep burning. Keep burning.
That fire take you up out of here.
Fire!
Keep burning. gotta pick your craft, your profession, like you would your soulmate. You gotta marry the one that sets you on fire. What makes you feel the most alive on the inside? Whatever that is, do that. Positive thinking is powerful, but you can't think your way to success. You have to burn your way there. So set yourself on fire with passion and pursue the things that make you feel alive. Climb on the wings of fire. Those who chase trends instead of pursuing their own truth disqualify themselves from greatness. The average person seeks a job or a product to sell, but the successful people, they seek the flame. Don't let the heat intimidate you. Fire is just a symbolic example to remind us of how we're supposed to live. The energy created when doing your passion is a gift from God. That's why there's so much power in it. Set yourself on fire and the world will come see you burn. Keep burning. Keep burning. Keep burning. That fire take you up out of here. Fire. Keep burning. Keep burning. Keep burning. That fire take you up out of here. Now here's the key to your success. As long as you continue to put money first, you'll never master it. But when you put fire, your passion, and truth where you place money, then money will find you. Cause money chases, stalks, seeks authenticity. Follow the smoke till you find your fire. Those who don't respect truth will choke on the lies and illusions of life. Surround yourself with those who can't breathe without your truth. Light up and set yourself on fire, and the world will come see you burn. If you ain't burning, you ain't living. Fire. I'm Billy Allsbrooks, and I am blessed and unstoppable. Fire, truth, news. Burn. And to God be the glory. Don't let the heat intimidate you. Truth is the new black, the couture for greatness. Get your t-shirts now at blessedandunstoppable.com. Join the movement. I discipline my body and make it my slave, so that after I have preached to others, I myself will not be disqualified. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline, where we get it in every day. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Grind City all day. If you wanna taste greatness, you gotta choke all that weakness, laziness, and fear out of you. You gotta kill it all. Until all that remains is a tap. It's not the politicians that change the world. It's the people with discipline. Those that can stay disciplined will eventually rule the world. Champions don't make excuses. They make adjustments. You see, excuses are infinite. Opportunities are rare. You gotta seize the moment. You can't breathe cause you choking on excuses. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline, where we get it in every day. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Grind City all day. I don't worry about the competition. You see, they can't swim. So all I gotta do to win is just drown them in sweat. Ain't no lifeguard out here gonna save you. You gotta learn to swim while you chasing trends on social media, looking for likes and chasing followers. I'm out here getting. That D don't stand for Dallas, it stands for discipline. Greatness requires learning how to be comfortable with the things that make you uncomfortable. While you taking selfies and playing with your Snapchat filters, I'm in the gym adding more weight to the bar. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline, where we get it in every day. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Grind City all day. I don't grind like this to be good. I don't grind and work like this to be great.
I got one vision and one vision only, and that's to be the best that's ever done this. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline, where we get it in every day. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Grind City all day.
A champion's life revolves around discipline, self-mastery, seizing control of one's own mind, and then harnessing the full potential and power of focused thought. One who is king of his own mind will eventually be king of the physical realm. Therefore, I don't dilute or pollute my mind with thoughts that produce average outcomes. All I project is greatness. I am constantly planning and cultivating an environment that is conducive to success. I'm a real interior designer. I get up every day and design my life from the inside out.
Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline, where we get it in every day. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Grind City all day.
I'm a beast, and you don't wanna mess with me.
I'm a beast,
and you don't wanna mess with me.
And all the champions say, I'm a beast.
You don't wanna mess with me.
I'm a beast,
and you don't wanna mess with me.
And all the champions say, I'm hungry, dedicated, and I'm fearless, hungry, dedicated, and I'm fearless, hungry, dedicated, and I'm fearless, hungry, dedicated. They don't want none. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline, where we get it in every day. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Welcome to the house of discipline. Grind City all day.
I bring every area of my life into submission. I walk at the highest level of self-discipline, consistently doing what it takes to be successful. Today I vow to conquer myself. Thank you, God, for giving me the strength to overcome me, for giving me the power to bring my mind and flesh under total control so I can glorify you in all things. This is Billy Allsbrook, and I am blessed and unstoppable. Grind City, to God be the glory. Let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. Now, the crown of victory must be seized by persistence. Champions understand that the secret to success is refusing to give up. Today, I will be teaching about the law of persistence. Now, let's look at the definition of persistence. The fact of continuing in an opinion or course of action in spite of difficulty or opposition. Class is in session, and I'm gonna break this law of persistence down into 5 points for you to understand. If you truly grasp and apply this principle, you will be unstoppable. Persistence is to consistently apply pressure with the corresponding actions required to produce success. Now, the way you apply pressure is you grind until the world folds unto your demands. Champions don't negotiate with the world. There's only one outcome, and that's the outcome they believe for, and they ain't settling for nothing less. They ain't no halfway victory, no halfway healing, no halfway championship, ain't no halfway legend. You gotta go all in, 120 beast mode, all the way. That's it, that's the identity of a champ. The first thing I want you to understand is the foundation that persistence rests upon, and that's a mindset. A mindset that believes with God all things are possible. Now let's go to the word. Joshua 1:5 says, no one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. So whatever situation, trial or tribulation that you are facing, understand this, you are not alone. Now we persist not in faith of our own ability, but in that of the God that we serve. You've heard me it. You seize the victory by faith. Persistence is faith sustained. It's faith proven day in and day out. Belief walked out. We are incapable of sustaining the persistence required for victory on our own. But our faith is the game changer, because it invites in God to our situation. And in His presence, we find the strength needed to press on, to keep going, to keep fighting. Now understand this. Breakthroughs are always available to those willing to think in a way that will allow them to manifest. You have to put your mind in an environment conducive to success and keep it there. The way you respond in the moment of trial will ultimately define you. Now remember, failure is not an option, because greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. Now the second point to persistence is to get a vision for where you're headed. Because you can't persist moving towards something if you don't know where you're going. You gotta see that victory in your mind. Vision is the genesis of all greatness. You build success one brick at a time in your mind. When the mind truly accepts the dream, the unseen will become seen. Your mind is the factory, and your dream is the product, and your grind is the worker that assembles it all together. And your persistence is your marketing. Now you Picasso, the painter, the artist. Your mind is the blank canvas. Your thoughts are the paintbrush. Now you pick up that paintbrush and you paint the victory. Where there is no vision, the people perish, right? So what I want you to do is unleash your imagination. Your imagination is power. It's a weapon. You go inside your mind and you build that outcome that you want. And then you live there. You live there till you can feel every sensation equivalent to you actually manifesting it. Your victory has always been there. But for the unseen to become seen, one must grab the dream with both hands and refuse to let go. And just like Jacob wrestled with the angel, you gotta wrestle with that dream and refuse to let go until it becomes a reality. Your faith must create an inner stillness during the gestation period. This is what the word says when it says, peace, be still, and know that I am God. God will take care of it. Your job is to stay in faith for the dream, believe for the promise. Don't get shaken out of your dream by the senses, by what you see on the outside, the external world. Because the external always bows down to the internal. The mental, the thinking dictates the environment. And the word says, be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. The transformative power is the thinking. The only thought should be victory. Your body is the temple. Your mind is the altar. And your thinking is the worship. Now, what God are you serving with your thinking? Now, point three is understanding the power created through persistence. See, by persistently focusing on God's goodness, greatness, and glory, our faith is increased to a level that will move mountains. Persistence is a catalyst for transformation. It creates the power needed for change. The more you persist, the more pressure you apply upon the world for it to deliver what God has already promised. What the enemy don't want you to understand is that persistence lifts you out of the world of darkness and into the light. You see, persistence is the devil, the enemy, Satan's kryptonite. When you remain steadfast, when your faith is unwavering, you expose the lies of the enemy. You expose his nothingness. All the obstacles and illusions that stand in the way of the promises of God fade away and bow down to the warriors that refuse to give up. Now, to fully tap into the law of persistence, we must do point four, which is examine the motives behind our persistence. Are we standing in faith for our will? Or are we standing in faith for God's will? The first thing we need to do is filter and verify everything that we are trusting God for through His word. The word is truth, and a disciplined mind rooted in truth can do the impossible. We always go back to the word to make sure what we are doing is in line with God's will. God cannot bless something that contradicts His word. It's against His nature. When alignment collides with persistence, miracles happen. I want you to remember this. The heart that persistence flows out of determines the outcome. So I ask you, are your motives righteous? Are they rooted in love? Are they aligned with the fruits of the Spirit? And if the answer to that is yes, then you have victory already. Because all the promises of God are yes and amen. And that brings us to point number five, God's response to our persistence. Now let's go to the Word. 1 John 5:14-15. And this is the confidence that we have toward Him, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. And if we know that He hears us in whatever we ask, we know that we have the request that we have asked for. Now see, God always honors the reacher. In exchange for our persistence, God gives us victory. Faith is the currency that miracles and victories are purchased with. All other currencies and forms of payments are denied. Faith is the only language spoken in heaven. All other languages are gibberish. Persistence is faith displayed, walked out day in and day out. It is the war cry of the believer. And God always hears His people. As long as you got breath in you, never ever give up. This is Billy Allsbrooks, and I am blessed and unstoppable. To God be the glory. Grind City. No longer shall my eternal spirit succumb to flesh. With the knives of discipline, I shall kill off the old me and give birth to the Superman. Superman. Superman, I killed off the old me. Superman, Superman, I killed off the old me. Superman, Superman, I killed off the old me. Superman, Superman, I killed off the old me. In the Superman movies, the worst mistake that Superman made was not killing off Clark Kent. To go to the next level, we must be willing to murder the lesser version of ourselves. Those who want to be massively successful must first take their mind and beliefs to the guillotine. Nietzsche said, you must be ready to burn yourself in your own flame. How could you arise anew if you have not first become ashes? Set yourself on fire, and the world will come see you burn. Some people who could lead the world are too addicted to being loved by others to actually do it. Somebody needs to hear this. You gotta stop playing small, timid, and scared because you're worried about what other people are gonna think. If your pursuit of greatness makes them uncomfortable, then that just disqualifies them from being in your future. There's two choices. You can either have their approval, or you can have greatness. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord, and we shall project His greatness. Those that burn will eventually slay the dark. The awakened one dreams away his life, unhindered by the world's illusions of limitations. He is fully conscious of his inner power to mold and shape the seen world. His dreams and creative imagination become the commands that dictate to the physical realm. Reality responds obediently to the desires thrust upon it, manifesting the grand will of the enlightened mind. I reject the old and give birth to the new. Clarity is the monster that devours all competition. I see myself with such penetrating awareness that it makes my dreams inevitable. Those that burn will eventually slay the dark. Superman! 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 I killed off the old me! 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 Self-awareness requires trading in one's mortal eyes for eternal ones. And with these eyes, no matter which way one looks, all that one can see is God. Superman! The common man sees greatness as something to achieve, as if greatness is an accomplishment. But the enlightened one, the Superman, understands that greatness is an identity. Life is constantly shifting to align with your acknowledged identity. Which version of you are you projecting?
For too long I drifted back and forth between the lesser me and the greater me. These two states have always been at war with one another, fighting over my destiny, until finally I became an assassin and murdered the inferior version of me. That timid and scared state of existence worried too much about what the world thought of me. I sought their approval. Greatness hides at the bottom of insanity. One must be willing to dive into the belly of madness to swim in the impossible. I left the herd and embraced the madness. You took my meekness for weakness. You thought because I granted you access that you had actually done something to earn it. Looking back at my life, I had a divine revelation. Every time somebody hurt me, it was because I allowed it. Every loss, defeat, and disappointment that I experienced, I allowed it. For so long in my life, I let the world tell me that I wasn't good enough. I had a mirror problem. The insecurities blocked my mind from seeing that I was fearfully and wonderfully made. I couldn't understand why my whole life I felt like I was outside the circle. I hated being different. I felt like nobody understood me. But one day I got divine revelation. Why should mere mortals understand the ways of the supernatural? Why should small town people understand the language of global ambitions? Why should sheep, why should the herd understand the ways of kings? Why should lukewarm people understand the ancient language of fire? Why should cowards understand the bravery of a warrior? Why should mortals understand the language of immortality? My mistake was thinking that the common person could spell the word legend. I had to be willing to go to the cross and crucify the lesser version of me. My whole life I had this potential, but never made the decision to go all the way. Finally, I dove deep under the shadows of truth and wisdom, where none of my adversaries could find me. The spirit said to me, greatness always runs contrary to the natural urges and desires of the flesh. I disciplined my body and make it my slave, so that after I have preached to others, I myself would not be disqualified. Billy Osbrooks, aka Superman, Superman, Superman. I killed off the old me. 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 The dead ghosts of museum walls haunt my pages. I hear them taunting those who were blind to that genius. These hydras now bury them in the halls of the establishment. My hands long to drip Jackson truth upon the minds of babies. Why should dead souls prevent the alive from living? Why should old money crush new ambition? Crippled eyes have no arms or legs, so why should we let them lead the revolution? We must pierce through the veils of illusions. The fire inside us must burn away their sheepish ignorance, feeling our memories. We must remember to feel that rejection cannot overcome our gorgeous rhythms. We must move towards our liberation from boundaries. Let us rise above and storm the bastions of tradition. God bless the critic who has mastered criticism, but let us not make apologies for glowing. Rebels of the aesthetic, I live in the sky, Superman. Those who believe in limitations have succumbed to the madness of illusions. Those who desire to be uncommon must first deal with the insanity of their common sense. The master key that unlocks all bondage is hidden in the mind of the one who thinks he's enslaved. These words are dangerous. I'm at war with the establishment. I am the voice for those that have none. God still moves. Dr. Billy Osbrooks, and I am blessed and unstoppable. Motivational art. Welcome to the loop. Impact 1 billion. And to God be the glory. Superman, Superman. Dr. Billy Osbrooks, I killed off the old me. Superman, Superman. Immortal legend, I killed off the old me. Superman, Superman. Blessed and unstoppable, I killed off the old me. Superman, Superman. By true music, I killed off the old me. If you spent as much time learning how to write a business plan as you did that new TikTok dance, you'd already be on that next level. Broken focus is the number one reason for failure. There's a price required for greatness. You have to hold every second of your life accountable to producing greatness.
You gotta establish the environment that gives birth to success.
Elon Musk said, nobody ever changed the world with a 40-hour work week. Some weeks he's working 120 hours, which allows him to do in 4 months what it takes other people to do in a year. Now he's able to do this because he's in the center of his calling. He is doing what he was assigned to do. And inside that calling, you will find strength and power that cannot be found elsewhere. Working 120 hours a week doesn't make sense to the common person who's working a job they were never designed to do. But when you're in your calling, your passion, doing the things that set you on fire, the clock becomes the enemy. This guy don't even want to go to sleep at night because he loves what he is doing. But that's why when mankind touches down for the first time on Mars, he will have gotten there on an Elon Musk rocket. Long live the wild beast. Dare to dream. And don't let nobody tell you that you can't do what God put inside you. Long live the wild beast. Smash the rules of complacent fools who cling to the comfort of yesterday. Long live the wild beast. Success is governed by the law of supply and demand. The universe will supply whatever your faith demands. What are you demanding of life? Where are you settling where you shouldn't be settling? Now, complacency is the device of the enemy. Complacency is an adversary of greatness. It is the opposition, and it is warring every single day over your future. Stop having affairs with average. I read this profound article on Michael Jordan. Now, Jordan said, winning has a price. Leadership has a price. So I pulled along people when they didn't want to be pulled. I challenged people when they didn't want to be challenged. I earned the right because my teammates who came after me didn't endure all the things that I endured. Once you joined the team, you lived at a certain standard that I played the game. And I wasn't going to take any less. Now many people criticize Michael Jordan's ruthless approach to the game. But that standard that he put in place allowed Chicago to win 6 titles in 8 years. Success has a price. Are you willing to pay it? I remember a few years ago watching this workout clip from NFL running back Derrick Henry. It was the summer of his junior year at the University of Alabama. The video showed him behind this F-150 pushing a truck around the track. And another clip showed him pulling that truck around the track, the whole track. The coaches weren't out there making him do that. He was doing it on his own. That's why he went on that year to win the Heisman Trophy. That's why last year he won the NFL rushing title. This guy had an NFL work ethic back in high school. Last fall, I was out in LA at the LA Charger training facility. The staff member told me that some of the coaches get there at 4 in the morning. And if they're lucky, they get out of there at 10 at night. To go to that next level, you gotta be devoted. You gotta be committed. You gotta be disciplined. You gotta be 120 all in pursuing your dream. The legend Kobe Bryant, his team practice used to start at 7 a.m. But every morning he got to the gym at 4 a.m. and put a 3-hour workout in before everybody else got there. It was the sweat that made him a legend. Now I want you to dream big. But you gotta remember that your work ethic must match the size of your ambition. Write this question down. Am I willing to pay the price to become the person that I want to be? For a dream to come alive, one must have absolute conviction that it will. To waver the slightest in belief is to put the dream in jeopardy of abortion. Don't you ever give up on that dream. Truth is the universal vaccine for all situations. The truth is you have a champion inside of you, and that champion is screaming to be unleashed. Don't wake the savage. If you spent as much time learning how to write a business plan as you did that new TikTok dance, you'd already be on that next level. Broken focus is the number one reason for failure. There's a price required for greatness. You have to hold every second of your life accountable to producing greatness. Are you willing to pay the price? Long live the wild beast. Dare to dream. And don't let nobody tell you that you can't do what God put inside you. Long live the wild beast. Smash the rules of complacent fools who cling to the comfort of yesterday. Long live the wild beast. Wild beasts are the bold thinkers imagining tomorrow. They usher in the revolution of dreams and battles. ambassadors of anarchy, smashing the rules that no longer serve us. Misunderstood by the masses, they are fluent in the language of genius. Warring with complacent fools who cling to the glory of yesterday. They are interior designers, constructing life from the inside out. It will take years for the world to fully understand the wild beasts and their ways. They envision what could be, what others couldn't see with mortal eyes. Daring and bold vagabonds, seeking refuge in the shadows of tomorrow. History will vindicate their courage to imagine. They wrestle violently with the bandits of small-time thinking. Madness of ingenuity, stubborn enough to take a stand. They are the masters of innovation, orchestrating the concertos of uprising. They are the radical, defiant rebels, armed with dangerous new thinking, articulating ideas well before their time.
Blind.
Long live the wild beast.
Dare to dream.
And don't let nobody tell you that you can't do what God put inside you.
Long live the wild beast.
Smash the rules of complacent fools who cling to the comfort of yesterday.
Long live the wild beast.
Ruthless dreams opposed in reality. Coup d'etat started by the imagination. Visions revolting. They scream down with the status quo. Riding into battle on Napoleon's gray horse. Married to the one that thinks differently. She was the apple in Steve Jobs' eyes. Breathing liberation, imagining nirvana. The death of madness shattering their lies. They are culture terrorists, inviting expulsion. Corrupted lenses distorting our perceptions. The Western Bin Ladens destroying convention. Strap bombs of enlightenment on their chests. Audacious blueprints, architects of truth. Pirates of creativity, conspiring with guerrillas. Painting portraits of change and human progress. Overthrowing the ways of the current order. They are the bold thinkers, imagining tomorrow. Ushering in the revolution of dreams. Ambassadors of anarchy, smashing the rules that no longer serve us.
Long live the wild beast.
Dare to dream. And don't let nobody tell you that you can't do what God put inside you.
Long live the wild beast.
Smash the rules of complacent fools who cling to the comfort of yesterday.
Long live the wild beast.
Are you willing to pay the price? I dare you to think different. I dare you to dream bigger. I dare you to pursue that greatness that's on the inside of you. Study and learn all the laws to success and then smash. Don't be scared to be you. Boldly pursue that which is on the inside of you. Put the standard in a place that produces greatness and go out there in the world and conquer.
Long live the wild beast.
This is Dr. Billy Osbrooks, and I am blessed and unstoppable. Impact 1 billion people. Motivational art. Welcome to the Louvre. Now let's close with the word. Acts 2:17. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams.
Ryan City.
And to God be the glory. Blessed and unstoppable. Success starts with putting the right things into your mind. And my new book, Blessed and Unstoppable, was strategically designed to align your mind with the laws of success. This curriculum will teach you the inner mechanics required to go from average to phenomenal. From living a life with limits to being blessed and unstoppable. As you follow this guide step by step, amazing breakthroughs will happen. New doors of opportunity will open and favor will begin to chase you down. Blessed and Unstoppable is a 31-day devotional on the laws of success. This book will instigate the thought process and actions required to transform your life. Each day has a Bible verse, a teaching on that day's principle, a positive affirmation, a prayer for the day, self-assessment questions, success quotes, action steps, and a powerful inspirational message. Regardless of what field you're in, Blessed and Unstoppable is your blueprint for success. Get your copy at blessedandunstoppable.com. Also available on Amazon.
The struggle is real, but you know you were meant for more. That dream that's on the inside of you just won't shut up. Cause you know you were meant for more. You've always been different. They never understood you. They've always doubted you. Cause you're different. But you know something that they don't know. You know, to be successful, you cannot follow the masses.
You gotta be different, and you are bold enough to be you. You've always been different.
Success ain't for everybody. B7U Clothing, wear your identity.